ओके, नवंबर 2020, 2021, पेपर 21। सो यू विल लर्न द स्किल्स हाउ टू राइट एक्सप्लेनेशन अच्छा इन पेपर 2। सो दिस इज विंटर 21, विंटर 20, वेरिएंट 21। Ionization energy in a group decreases from top to bottom. Okay, so write an equation for the first ionization energy. First thing is, most of the student make mistake, they don't write proper symbol. Element must be in the gaseous state. Okay, the next part is okay. I write here again, it is the amount of energy required to remove 1 mole of electron from 1 mole of gaseous atom of an element. Gaseous atom of an element. 1 mole electron. Okay, this is ionization energy. Explain the observed trend in the first ionization energy down the group. Look at this graph. It is decreasing down the group, right? So how will you write answer? This time they ask 3 marks. So whenever in group, please memorize it. In group, you have to write first point, distance from atomic radii or distance from nucleus increases. First point in a group when distance from nucleus increases in a group from top to bottom, shell increases, due to which number of occupying shell increases. So the shell, occupied shells shield the nucleus attraction on the valence shell. For lithium, suppose for beryllium 2 2, for calcium magnesium 2 8 2, 10 electrons are shielding this 2 electron, 2 electrons are shielding, inner shell electron shield. Calcium 2 8 8 2, so 18 electrons are shielding the attraction of nucleus on the valence electron. So shielding effect increases down the group. Okay, one more thing that I wished you should write, because it's not mentioned even though here, but you can say that nuclear charge also increases, but its nuclear charge factor is not significant in a group from top to bottom, because shielding effect factor outweighs the nuclear charge factor. I wish you should write this word, nuclear charge. Increase in nuclear charge. Okay, the examiner will be very happy. If it is a 4 mark question, once it was asked 4 mark question, the same trend in 2005. So examiner expected this answer also. Nuclear charge also increases, but it is outweighed by the shielding effect factor in a group. So attraction of nucleus decreases. This is important point. Attraction of nucleus decreases, so less energy is required. Don't write easier or difficult. Less, we are talking about energy. Less energy is required to remove electron. Got it? First point, in a group from top to bottom, the distance of electron. What distance? Distance of electron. Distance of electron from nucleus increases down the group. So due to which the shielding effect increases. What shields? Electrons in the inner shell shield the attraction of the nucleus. So nuclear charge also increases because atomic number 2, 12, 20, but the increase in the nuclear charge factor is outweighed, is not significant in the presence of shielding effect factor. So we say shielding effect factor outweighs the minor increase in the nuclear charge. Okay, now got it. The second ionization energy of beryllium is this. Explain why the second ionization of beryllium is higher than that of the first ionization energy. See, this is beryllium. After beryllium has 4 proton, 4 electron. This is beryllium plus 4 proton, 3 electron. Okay. So what is the difference in these two? Beryllium plus is smaller than beryllium. Hence, attraction of nucleus on valence electron is stronger. More energy is required. To remove electron. Okay. Phosphorus reacts with an oxygen to form phosphorus 5 oxide. Phosphorus 5 oxide is phosphorus, you can say P4 solid plus oxygen. Phosphorus common oxide is P4O10 solid 5O2. Okay. Describe the reaction of phosphorus with water is highly exothermic. Don't even try to do it in the school lab if you find phosphorus oxide. Okay, examiner has written in the examiner report that many students have written instead of P4O10, P2O5. Keep in mind, P2O5 is the empirical formula of P4O10. It's not the molecular formula. It's the empirical formula. Okay. So, P4O10, I show you the reaction with water. Few seconds video. Look, 1 minute. So you can see this. This bottle has phosphorus oxide P4O10. Highly exothermic reaction. You will see the observation, then you can write. See, what did you observe? Steamy fumes. Okay. He added only few drops. If you add more water, it will be completely soluble in water. So, what is the observation that you can write here? Write an equation. Okay, you have done. You did this part. Okay. P4. Plus 5O2 gas P4O10. Describe the reaction. They didn't say observation. Describe the reaction. So describe P4O10 reacts. What did you observe? Violently with water. With water forming steamy fumes. These steamy fumes is actually water vapor with a highly exothermic reaction. So water evaporates. The reaction is exothermic, highly exothermic. Steamy fumes. Phosphoric acid is formed. Actually, the equation you are not supposed to write, but P4O10 plus water H3PO4. This is the equation. This is the equation. Phosphoric acid is dissolved, soluble. Colorless solution is formed. In observation, you can also write colorless solution is formed. Okay. Achha. Structure and bonding. So when we say bonding, so non-metal, non-metal, phosphorus and oxygen is bonding, is non-metal, non-metal has covalent. And P4O10 is a simple molecular, small molecule. Simple molecular structure. Non-metal, non-metal, no significant polarity is there. Simple molecular structure means small bond. There will be polarity, but overall, the structure is simple molecular, not giant covalent. Okay. Now, the two common oxides of sulfur is sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. When sulfur dioxide dissolves in water, explain why weak acid is formed. What are the first? Let me do this, then we'll define sulfur dioxide plus water, sulfuric 4 acid, we call sulfurous, minus 6 plus 2 plus 4, we call sulfuric 4 acid, and old name is sulfurous acid. OUS shows that one O is less, because sulfuric means 4 oxygen and sulfurous means 1 oxygen less. This is old name. This is new name. 4 is the oxidation state of sulfur. Weak Bronsted-Lowry acid means acid which accepts proton acid, which gives proton partially, because a weak acid, weak also you have to include proton partially. Acid is proton donor, is acid, Bronsted-Lowry acid. Weak, we use the word partially. Okay. Both are gases? No. Someone has asked question that sulfur dioxide, water, liquid, sulfurous acid, it is liquid, aqueous solution. Okay. Now, sulfur dioxide reacts with nitrogen dioxide in the atmosphere to form sulfur trioxide. And this chapter is nitrogen and sulfur chapter in organic chemistry. So you know there are two types of catalysis, homogeneous and heterogeneous catalysis. In this, nitrogen dioxide is catalyst gas. This is also gas. and it is regenerated in the second step. Role of NO2 because it is regenerated, or it is a catalyst. Which type of catalyst? Homogeneous catalyst. Homogeneous catalysis. This reaction is homogeneous catalysis, but the overall equation is this one. If you want to ask overall equation, if you write overall equation, the overall equation will be this. If you multiply this equation by 2, okay, and then add this 2 NO cancel, this 2 cancel, 2 SO2 plus O2, 2 SO3. This is the overall equation. Or SO2 plus half O2, SO3. This is the overall equation. Okay. Emission of sulfur dioxide from coal power station reduced by mixing coal with powdered limestone. Okay, equation one, limestone is crushed first. Calcium oxide reduces sulfur dioxide to form, in the presence of more oxygen, to form calcium sulfate. This is a direct reaction, keep in mind. Because your past paper also asked what will be the equation. So calcium sulfide is the product, which on further oxidation forms calcium sulfate. First calcium sulfide is formed. Okay. Equation one. What do you call equation one? Thermal decomposition. Yes, you are heating it. You can say thermal decomposition. Okay, then Hess's law. Use the data to calculate the enthalpy change of reaction 2. This is 2. Can I write this equation here? Calcium oxide plus sulfur dioxide. What do you call this reaction? So what values are given? Formation values are given. It means if you want to solve by Hess's law, there are two methods. This is given, this value is given, elements to element zero. This is all three values are given. Calcium oxide -635, sulfur dioxide -297. This one is -1434. So one method is this one. This is method one I'm doing. Hess's law cycle. So what did Hess said? These are the reactants. This is the product. So if you go this way, Mr. Hess said, if you go, this is the route one. And if you go this way, route two, the value will be same. So there is no space, so I'm doing it here. So this way means delta H of this reaction is equal to, when you come this way, the arrow goes down, right? So arrow goes down, I'm using green pen. This way, it will be plus 6035. Plus this also, plus 297. So plus 6035. Plus 297, plus. Now you go this way. This arrow is already going there. Minus 1434. What is the value? What is the answer? This minus 502 R. Is it there? Minus 502 kilojoule per mole. I think that is the answer. Are you getting it? Okay, there's a shortcut also. Achha, you can say, I don't want this changing the sign. Okay, you don't want, then there's another. We can do another two routes also. Okay, if you don't want route one, that one, keep in mind, this is A, this is B, this is C. Elements be right here because formation values are from the elements. So if I say A to B 1, X we have to find, A to C is 2. So you can also write now 1 plus X is equal to 2. There is no need to change the sign. I mean, this one is minus 635. This one is minus 297. This one is minus 1434. So this 2 is this one. 1 is, this is 1. X is X. So you can make the equation how minus 635 plus minus 297 plus X is equal to this, this, and this is the second root, minus 1434. Okay, same answer. Okay. Method 2 is more, I think method 2 will be very easy for you. It is easier than the method 1, is formula method. What formula? Delta H of reaction is equal to total enthalpy change of formation of products, enthalpy change of formation of reactant. Okay. Got it? Achha. Product kitna hai? What is the product? What was the equation? This one is, this is the product. Minus 1434 minus. These are the reactant. Minus 635 plus minus 297. Same answer, minus 502 kilojoule per mole. So method 2, formula method, this is easier. It's only, I think, 2 mark question. So there's no restriction of using formula. This formula is also derived from the Hess's law cycle. So you can say it is also based on Hess's law cycle. Got it. Okay. Part D. Draw dot and cross model diagram of Cl2O. Achha. For dot and cross diagram, I suggest my student to do one thing. Which one is the central atom? Oxygen. If you do follow my this method, this rules, some rules, so I think is you can avoid errors. Central atom, oxygen, and write its old group number, like new group, group 16, right? But we write 6 just for you. Group 16. From here you will know how many valence electron is there. Then which one is the attached atom? Chlorine. Group of chlorine is 17. Okay, you should keep in mind it is 7. Write with pencil, 7. Okay, so valency of attached atom. Valency of attached atom You write one. Chlorine, if it is at, as an attached atom, its valence is usually one. Huh, when it is a central atom, it may form more than one bond also. So you can make circle also and without circle also. This is chlorine should be bigger technically. Oxygen, chlorine is in third period, will be bigger. Oxygen group 16, acha one valency mean chlorine electron. Oxygen electron. Now oxygen is in group 6, two electrons are used, four are left. Chlorine is in group 17, I mean 7 previous one, so one electron is involved, three are left, three pairs are left, six are left. And better in your rough work, you draw like this first. This is also correct. This is also correct if you want to save your time. No, no. If you don't make it, if you don't care about the size of, it's okay. But you have to keep your... aim as, you know, less, we say usually keep your aim high. Aim is world distinction. So world distinction means you have to care according, you have to write your answer in like in an excellent way. Okay, okay. The next part is oxidation number. Chlorine is zero here. This is no value. Sodium plus one, chlorine minus one. Oxygen minus two, two oxygen minus four, chlorine plus four. Okay. So the answer was 0. Chlorine is plus 4 here, minus 4 oxygen, and chlorine is plus 1 here. Sorry, minus 1 here. Plus 1 sodium, minus 1 chlorine. Okay, now equilibrium. State and explain the effect on the yield. When the yield is asked, forget about the rate. And when rate is asked, forget about the yield. For yield, at 1000 Kelvin. Here it was 500 Kelvin. Now 1000 Kelvin. Temperature increased. So first you see, if the examiner asks about yield, first you see what is about forward reaction is exo or endo. Exo. Reverse is endo. Keep one rule, increasing the temperature shift the equilibrium towards endo. So equilibrium will be shifted forward is exo. So equilibrium will be shifted towards backward direction. So there will be less product. So yield will decrease. So first state. So you get one mark. State. Yield decreases. Okay, one mark you got. Now explain, as the forward reaction is exothermic, increasing the temperature will shift the equilibrium. Equilibrium to towards backward direction. According to Le Chatelier. So examiner will be very happy according to Le Chatelier's principle. So if you write this, then examiner will be very happy. Okay. अच्छा जी इरेज कैन आई इरेज ओके नाउ द इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रेशर प्रेशर वाज हियर 500 किलो पास्कल नाउ 500 किलो पास्कल इंक्रीज So, if you want to see the effect of pressure on yield, we have to see the moles of gases. 2 moles, 2 moles, 1 mole, 2 mole. On product side, there are 3 moles. And on reactant side, there are more moles. So, you know, according to Le Chatelier principle, when you increase the pressure, as number of moles on product of products smaller than number of moles of reactant. Okay. Increasing the pressure shifts the equilibrium towards less number of mole, right? Towards less number of moles. That is product side. Hence, yield increases. Okay, so when you want to see the effect of pressure on the yield, we have to consider volume of moles of gases. Only gases moles, not solid, not liquid. Okay. Element is the period 5 element. Period 5 element. Okay, they didn't say mention about the group. But you can guess from this element. This period 2, 1, 2, period 3, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon. This is period 3. Apply the same rule there. Period 5, I can make. Period 4 is calcium, potassium. Rubidium is here. Strontium is here. Boron, aluminum. Gallium, indium. Tin. Sulfur, arsenic, antimony, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, iodine, helium, neon, or xenon, I think. This is period 5. Achha ji, this is period 3. Element E, this is not necessary, you should know. Okay. E reacts with oxygen to form insoluble white oxide. Insoluble white oxide, apply here. these three oxides are insoluble. Magnesium oxide, aluminum oxide, silicon oxide. So we have to see whether we can apply these rules here also or not. But problem is period 5, strontium oxide is soluble. So it is not group 2 element. Not group 1 element. Group 1 element oxide is soluble. High melting point. Oxide conducts electricity only when liquid. It means the bond is ionic. Ionic bond in oxide of E. How do we know? Only ionic compounds conduct electricity when molten. Okay. So it means silicon dioxide is not possible. Period 5, I mean group period 3 is possible. I mean group 3 element is possible like aluminum. E also reacts with chlorine to form a white solid that reacts exothermically with water. This group 1 element chloride just dissociate in water. Same group 2. So it's not group 1, group 2. It's period 3, but it's like it can be like group P, group 3 element. Like aluminum chloride also reacts violently with water. Silicon chloride also react violently with water. It means its chloride is covalent chlorides. Covalent chlorides, write a rule. Covalent chlorides react, get hydrolyzed easily. Get hydrolyzed. Hydrolyzed means they react with water forming compounds. Get hydrolyzed. Okay. Suggest the type of bonding shown in E. Explain your answer. E has ionic bond. Ionic bond in oxide as it only conducts electricity because oxide only conducts electricity in molten state. Okay, 2 marks. I think 1 mark is for ionic bond, one mark for the reason because it conducts electricity in molten state. Say the type of bonding shown in the chloridophile, covalent bonding in chloride. Of E. Why? Because it forms a white solid that reacts exothermically with water. Okay. So chloride, because it's chloride, reacts readily with water. I mean, gets hydrolyzed easily. So covalent chlorides gets hydrolyzed easily. Okay. So we don't need to know the period 5. We don't need to know group period 5 or if period 3, we can guess it's aluminum. Okay. Aluminum chlorides bonding too much in this paper, right? Il-2-Hill-6 additive bonding structure. I tell my students the technique, you remember like this. One aluminum, two chlorine here. One aluminum, two chlorine here. And the third one, if it's here, then its third one should be like this. And these two make dative bond, if you remember. This is dative bond. These two are dative bond. This chlorine, because aluminum had incomplete octet, 6 electrons, so this chlorine stabilizes this one, and this chlorine stabilizes this aluminum. Okay. State the bond angle in AlCl3. AlCl3 is very common. AlCl3, AlF, AlBr3, similar. BF3, BCl3, they all are trigonal planar and 120 degree angle. 120 degree. Okay, amazing. Okay, lithium atomic number is 3. Lithium plus means 2 electron. 2 electron means 1s2. H minus, H has 1 electron. Minus means 2, 1s2. Metallic bonding is 100% O level. Okay. What? That in metals, the valence electrons are lost. And the nucleus become positive ion. These electrons remain delocalized in the lattice. The attraction between... Oh, it's 1 mark question. Oh my God. 1 mark, you can just write the attraction between the... Between delocalized electrons... C of delocalized electrons and positive ions in the lattice. Okay, for 1 mark it is enough. Lithium aluminum hydride cannot be used in aqueous solution because it reacts with water readily to produce lithium hydroxide, hydrogen, and a white precipitate which is soluble in excess NaOH. Okay, let me tell you one thing, because most of you may not know because it's not taught to you. Aluminum hydroxide is similar to aluminum oxide, it's amphoteric. It is not base. Looks like base, right? It reacts with NaOH. Okay. Name the white precipitate that is aluminum hydroxide. Because aluminum ion, you know, it's insoluble in NaOH. Achha. So, lithium aluminum hydride, I mean, it reacted with water. Because they show it reacted with water. Forming hydrogen gas, lithium hydroxide plus aluminum hydroxide. Okay. Next thing is, this reaction is organic chemistry. 2-hydroxybutanoic acid is the compound. Two students try to prepare. Both students oxidize butane, 1,2-diol, this one. So they try it from here. So now you have to start, remember primary alcohol oxidation. This is CH2OH. This is primary. This is CHOH. This is secondary. So if it is confusing, you write, make it like this. CH3, CH2, C. CH2OH. Okay. This one you made like this. So if CHOH means 2 degree, this is primary. 2 degree alcohol forms ketone. Primary alcohol on oxidation forms carboxylic acid. Okay. LiLH4 reducing agent. Keep in mind, NaBH4 can reduce ketone to 2 degree alcohol. Write down the rule. Or LiLH4 reduces ketone, aldehyde, and carboxylic acid also. So, have you written the rule? So, LiLH4, this one will be reduced, this one also reduces. This will form secondary alcohol again. And this will form like CH2OH. So I am making first normal one, then skeletal. This CH3, CH2, COHH, CH2OH. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you want to make like that, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is OH, or this is also OH. Again, you got back this one. And NaBH4 will reduce ketone only. Only ketone, not carboxylic acid. So NaBH4 can reduce ketone to secondary alcohol, but not carboxylic acid. So you got the compound. R is basically 2-hydroxybutanoic acid. So you have observed the difference between the behavior of two reducing agent. LiLH4 is a stronger reducing agent than NaBH4. Okay. For reaction one is the oxidation. Oxidation involved for the alcohol, the best answer is acidified potassium dichromate 6. This is the best one. KMnO4 is not the best one. And the examiner in the recent mark scheme, they write only dichromate. See, I show you this mark scheme also. I show you the mark scheme. Question number, it was 3C, right? 3C, 1, oxidizing agent. 3C1. C, potassium dichromate. Acidified, 1 mark. Heat under reflux. This is the condition. Potassium dichromate. Examiner will accept acidified KMnO4, but dichromate is the best one. Most of the books, and they have mentioned it, that dichromate is the most suitable oxidizing agent, okay, for alcohol. Okay, KMnO4 can be used, but it sometimes oxidizes further. Okay, that's why we use dichromate. So you should also use dichromate. So R is T 2 and 3, so you know the difference between 2 and 3. In 2, this will become this is OH and this is OH. Same you got back. Carboxylic acid also reduced to primary alcohol. And in R, only this alcohol, only this group is reduced and not the carboxylic group. These two are reducing agent. Okay? So you will write accordingly. Now, a third student prepares 2-hydroxybutanoic acid in the presence of this. Okay, this nucleophilic addition. Identify the ion that reacts with the propanol. This is catalyst, aldehyde ketone. So we have to make the mechanism CN lone pair, first polarity, dipole, partial charges done. All charges done. Curly arrows, lone pair done. There are two curly arrows will be here. Okay. In the the structure of an intermediate form, this is. What actually happens further, they didn't ask in the mark, and but actually what happens, like HCN, this O oxoanion attacks. So you get CN minus also as a catalyst. Okay. O minus attacks on the hydrogen of the HCN. But you don't have to show this thing because examiner has not mentioned. But you should remember that. Yes. Okay. This is the normal mechanism we teach you. Nucleophilic addition. One arrow, second arrow. Oxoanion is formed. And in the second step, like this is catalyst. So catalyst must be regenerated, right? You should practice like this for nucleophilic addition. Practice like this, nucleophilic addition. But in this particular question, examiner did not ask you to what happens in the second step. So examiner didn't make this in the marking scheme. And cyanide is attached with the carbon, right? Not with the oxygen. So just want to show you some for a lighter note because everyone is... Man is weak, okay? And man, everyone can commit errors. So examiner report I was reading. So in the examiner report, the funny thing is that they wrote here, see, can you see the examiner report? The attack on the aldehyde carbon is followed by the breaking of pi bond of the carbonyl group to form an intermediate. Intermediate, what happens? Cyanide group is attached with the carbon, right? Cyanide group is attached with the positively charged oxygen atom. This is wrong in the examiner report, and everyone, it's not I'm boasting myself, every one of you knows that is wrong. So cyanide group is attached and a positively charged cyanide with a cyanide group attached and a positively charged oxygen atom. It's not positively charged, negatively charged. Okay. So everyone can make mistake. Okay, ji. So everyone, human is weak. Okay. So Allah has said that we have created man weak. Okay, this is the mechanism that you were supposed to draw. Cyanide hydrolysis equation, I think alkaline hydrolysis also and acid hydrolysis also you must memorize. This as I think you should learn this equation. H plus or HCl, whatever this, plus water, carboxylic group, plus ammonium. If you are using HCl, then it will be Cl here. Memorize this equation. Okay. Plus HCl plus water, ammonium chloride. Cyanide group is converting into carboxylic acid. Acid hydrolysis. Okay. It's called acid hydrolysis. Okay, where is the step two? This is the step two. OH as it is cyanide converted into carboxylic acid. For that reaction, you were supposed to write balancing here. Okay. I write again HCl plus 2 water plus ammonium chloride. Okay. Achha. Part 5, if I show you, but you must memorize it, above 1500 infrared spectrum is very clear. After 3200, if it is broad peak like this, 3200 to 3600, it is OH. Okay. Achha. Deduce and identify the compound. Give two reasons of your answer. Achha. The infrared spectrum of organic compound is shown. The organic compound is either S or 2-hydroxybutanoic acid. Where is S? This is S. Okay. This is S. I draw S here. C2H5. Okay. Then we will discuss which one is this. C2H5OHCNH. This is S. And butanoic acid? 1, 2. Hydroxybutanoic acid. If COOH group were there, then there would be a broad peak of 2500 to 3000 for OH of carboxylic group. OH of carboxylic group, which is missing here. It means it is not hydroxybutanoic acid. And it merges with the OH peak, and there's a big peak of hydroxides of hydroxypropanoic acid around 2500 to 3200. Okay. This one starts from 3200, means it has OH. Cyanide group has 2250. Has almost cyanide group IR spectrum. So it is S. These two, number one, what, how will you write? Number one. So this one, 32, 33. So there's a broad peak of at 3300. suggests OH of alcohol. ये देखें, ओके. सेकंड पॉइंट, यू विल कोट पीक एट शार्प पीक एट 2200 अप्रॉक्सीमेटली सजेस्ट साइनाइड ग्रुप. ओके, no peak of OH of carboxylic group and carbonyl group is present. Carbonyl group ki around 1700, C double bond group has around 1700 roughly, which is also not here. It means it's not carboxylic group. Okay, let's go. So copy it. Done. Okay, do. State and explain the trend in volatility in halogens. You know, in halogens, if you see boiling point increases, and if you see volatility, ability to vaporize decreases. Never write fluorine is a gas, bromine is liquid, iodine is solid. So volatility decreases. No, that is not the answer. So what is the answer? Down the state, first write state. Volatility decreases down the group 17. This is 1 mark. Reason: volatility depends on intermolecular force. An intermolecular force in halogen is van der Waal. Van der Waal becomes stronger. Why? Because van der Waal is proportional to number of electrons. Number of electrons increases down the group, due to which strength of intermolecular force induced dipole, you'll be induced dipoles becomes increases. Bas sahi. So volatility decreases down the group means the intermolecular force becomes stronger down the group. Okay, volatility, ability to vaporize. Okay, so down the group the halogen becomes halogen has stronger attraction between molecules, right? Okay, why HI is thermally least stable? Okay, thermal stability depends on bond energy, but and indirectly depends upon bond length. See, fluorine is smaller, H chlorine is bigger, bromine is further, iodine is bigger. So the bond energy and bond energy in turns depends on bond length, also bond polarity, also polarity, also electronegativity decreases, so polarity also decreases. Bond length increases, so bond energy decreases. So bond energy of HI bond is least, 1 mark you will get. But if you want world distinction, as hydrogen iodide bond is biggest with least polarity, so this part if you are very confident, then you write. This will be the world distinction answer. Okay, distinction answer. I mean, not only this is. Okay, I'm not boasting, but many of my students and tuition student also have got distinction. Okay, so and we discuss with the examiners also, Cambridge trainers, what are the features in the distinctions like answers. Explain in terms of intermolecular force why HI has a lower boiling point than HF. Okay, so I ask you which type of intermolecular force is present in HF. Three element, fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen, forms hydrogen bonding. Okay, hydrogen bonding is a type of permanent dipole, but is the strongest intermolecular force. We should mention hydrogen bonding. Okay, HI, you can say, has a permanent dipole also and induced dipole also. Okay, it's not much polarity, both, which both are weaker than the but mainly HI has, examiner has accepted both answer in the marking scheme, like if you mention HF, but examiner again did one silly mistake here, which is not done by other examiners. HF has hydrogen bonding, which is the strongest, and when we teach you and all the books, when they teach this graph, boiling point, HF, hydride of group 7, HCl, HBr, HI, okay? They all mention, because HF has hydrogen bonding. These three elements form hydrogen bonding. But the chief examiner, by mistake, chief examiner, in the examiner report, by mistake, wrote permanent dipole in HF is stronger than the HI. So again, this is not the best answer. Again, I told the chief examiner is a human. So this mistake is never done by any other examiner earlier in all the books, because you are supposed to write from the books. They have mentioned HF has the highest boiling point because of the hydrogen bonding, which is the strongest. Let me show you chief examiner's examiner report answer. Okay. Yes. No, Achai, Mark scheme, I think they have mentioned. Mark scheme. Wow. Question 4. Look here, in the marking scheme, HF has permanent dipole. It is there, permanent dipole, but HF has high melting point because of the hydrogen bonding. Because permanent dipole is also there in the HI also little. And HI has only instantaneous dipole, they accepted induced dipole, they accepted, even they accepted permanent dipole also. So how can we compare if the exam? So HF, this is the common error, is not the best answer in the marking scheme. So HF has hydrogen bonding, which is the strongest intermolecular force, while HI, you can say, has both permanent and induced dipole both. Keep in mind, most of the students do not know that induced dipole, write down, is present in all the molecules, but it is not significant in the polar molecules having hydrogen bonding, but it is present there. Like there was a question, I think this was the question, urea, in past paper. in 1, 2, 3 option. It has hydrogen bonding, yes, because hydrogen is attached with the nitrogen. If FON has hydrogen attached, then it will have hydrogen bonding. It has hydrogen bonding, yes. The second option, it has permanent dipole. Here it has permanent dipole also. This is permanent dipole. And the third one was, it has induced dipole. And the answer, this one also correct. Induced dipole is present in all the molecules, whether it is polar or non-polar. But in non-polar, induced dipole will be the major intermolecular force. And in polar molecule, induced dipole will not be the major intermolecular force. Okay? Got it? This is... okay. Achha ji. So what will you write the answer? HF is the strongest intermolecular force, which is hydrogen bonding, while HI has weaker intermolecular force, which is little permanent dipole and van der Waal force, whatever is there. Okay. Iodine reacts with hot concentrated aqueous sodium. Let's see this examiner report, what it examiner has mentioned. Examiner mentioned that this one, thermal stability. Okay, this bottom. Electronegative had intermolecular force. IMF will lower the boiling moment. HF has a strong intermolecular hydrogen bond. See, chief examiner has written correct. Strong intermolecular hydrogen bonds. But the marking scheme is wrong. Okay. And the van der Waal force, this term is the last year you are using van der Waal force. Okay. Next year, from the next year, you cannot use van der Waal force for non-polar, for instantaneous dipole. The definition for the van der Waal force is the general. Van der Waal force means all the types of intermolecular force. Now, okay, after June 2021, because the new syllabus is there. In the new syllabus, syllabus 2022, right, you will study from August. In that syllabus, the definition of van der Waal is different. Okay, that is a common general intermolecular force. Van der Waal means all types of intermolecular force. Okay. Okay, part four, we can do very quickly. Iodine reacts with hot constant is similar to the chlorine reaction. You must memorize this chlorine reaction with cold dilute and hot concentrated. This is for chlorine. Same, right? Same thing for iodine, hot NaOH. Instead of chlorine, you write here I. Instead of chlorine, write I. Okay, this reaction, hot concentrated NaOH and chlorine reaction is given in the book, so we can go fast. Okay, the last question. CH3 can be made from methanol. Identify reagent. Okay. Substitution reaction. OH to I. You have to substitute. You can use hydrogen iodide or you can use phosphorus Pi3, but red phosphorus plus iodine plus heat. Okay. 1,2-diiodoethane can be made by bubbling ethene into liquid. Type of mechanism. Okay. Ethene plus iodine. So you can make, yes, 1,2-diiodo. What type of reaction is in alkene? This is electrophilic addition. Electrophilic addition. In alkene, reactions are electrophilic addition with halogen. Name J. J is how to name first number 1, 2, 3, 4. 2-iodo, 2-methyl butane. Fully name the mechanism of the reaction of J with NaOH to form K. Okay. Iodine is replaced, substituted by OH. It means substitution. Which type of substitution? Nucleophilic substitution. You don't have to mention SN1 or SN2. only nucleophilic substitution. Okay, halogen alkane. Last part, I think. This is elimination reaction because halogen alkane NOH in ethanol elimination. Elimination, there are two possibilities. H is either removed from left side or right side. In this example, LH is removed from this carbon star. So double bond is formed here. If on the left hand side, then double bond will be between 1 and 2. Okay, L does not show geometrical isomerism because the double bond, this is L. Achha. Double bonded carbon has both groups same. If the two groups of the double bonded carbon atoms are same, two groups of double bonded carbon are alike, there will be no cis trans isomerism. If the double bond has two same groups, there will be no cis trans isomerism. Okay, L reacts with hot concentrated KMnO4 to form propanone and other product. Okay, L. For hot concentrated KMnO, we have to keep in mind double bond ruptures. This carbon has no hydrogen, it form ketone. Okay, and this carbon has one hydrogen, it form carboxylic acid. So you have to recall the reaction of alkene with the hot concentrated KMnO4. So propanone and this product, ethanoic acid. Name the other organic product, ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid. Propanone, this iodoform reaction. Okay, this balancing observation of yellow PPT. Okay, iodine balancing you can do, but remember here three. When you remember here three, there will be three here because three iodine is, and CHI3 is there. Here it is balanced, one, three iodine and three water balance. What is the observation of iodoform yellow PPT? That's all for today. I think it's finished. Yes, it's finished. Okay. That's all for today.